I'm going to cover consecutive integer problems. So let's start off with examples of two consecutive integers. Consecutive means just one after the next. So if the first one is 5, the next number would be 6. Those are two numbers in a row, right? How about, let's say, 10 and 11? Those are two consecutive integers. You could also have a negative number, so like you could have negative 8, and the next number after negative 8 would be negative 7. Think of the number line, etc. So these are some examples of two consecutive integers. Now let's say, instead of a specific integer that you know, you're going to have to use variables. You don't know what the first one is, but let's say the first one is n. What would be the next integer? So we don't know what n stands for. What would be the next one? Well, look at, see what I did on each of these. If I knew what the first one is, to get to the second one, you add 1. So if the first number is n, the second number would be n plus 1. So to define two consecutive integers, you would say the first one is n, and then you would say the second one would be n plus 1. That's how you could define two consecutive integers. What if you were asked to define three consecutive integers? Well, again, let's just think of some examples first. So examples might be 5, 6, and 7, right? Or how about 22, 23, and 24? Or let's say we have some negative numbers, like negative 10, then the next one would be negative 9 and negative 8. So hopefully you're getting the idea. So if I were going to define three consecutive integers, I'm going to say the first number, let's call it this way, the first, the second, and the third numbers. All right, we always want to start off with the first one just being n. What would the next consecutive integer be? Add 1. But how would I get the third number? You add 1 again. So that's how you would define three consecutive integers. I'm going to do a problem where we have to define some consecutive integers, and then we'll go on to what if it's talking about consecutive odd integers or consecutive even integers. We'll start off with just consecutive integer problem. Find three consecutive integers whose sum is negative 81. All right, so we know we're looking for three consecutive integers, so that's how we want to start off defining our variables. So we've got the first number, let's remember to call that n, and since they're consecutive, it's easy. N plus 1 is the next one, and the third number is n plus 2. Now, it says their sum is negative 81, so basically we're adding the first number to the second number to the third number, and we should get negative 81. I get the idea, I'm going to end up having some negative numbers here. So that's how we're going to do our equation. So the first number is just n, plus the second number is n plus 1. I'm going to use a different color so it's easier to see it. And the third number is n plus 2. So those are our three consecutive integers, and that equals negative 81. So there's our equation. Now we're going to go ahead and solve this equation. So we're going to add the like terms on the left side. 3n plus 3 is negative 81. Subtract 3 from both sides. And be careful with your positive and negative signs here. We have 3n is negative 84. And then we need to divide both sides by 3 so that n equals negative 28. All right, now the question is find three consecutive integers. So now that we know what n is, that stands for the first one. So the first number must be negative 28, and then what would the next one be? Add 1 to that, and add 1 to that. Now let's add those up. They're all going to be negative, so I can just put a negative sign, and if I add that up, I get 81, which is right. You're not used to adding negatives up and down. You might want to show your check this way. Negative 28 plus negative 27 plus negative 26 equals negative 81. Okay, that's the check. And now, of course, we have to answer the question that's being asked. Find three consecutive integers. So we say the integers are negative 28, negative 27, and negative 26. And that's an example of a consecutive integer problem. All right, here's another consecutive integer problem. Find two consecutive integers if 3 times the smaller integer is 12 more than twice the larger integer. All right, so we have to begin by defining our variables, and we've got a first and second, but I'm going to write that instead as the smaller and the larger number this time, since it happens to use the word smaller and larger. But these are consecutive integers, so if the first one's n, the second one will be one more, which is n plus 1. All right, so what's it say? 3 times the smaller is 12 more than twice the larger. So we can do a little bit of English and algebra together here. What it's saying, I'm going to do 3 times whatever that smaller number is, right? That's going to be the same as 12 more. That means I'm going to add 12, right, to something. To what? Twice the larger. Twice the larger number. All right, so let's do that. 3 times the smaller will be 3, and the smaller one is n, so I'm going to put in n for the smaller. That's the same as 2 times the larger number. Now the larger number is n plus 1, so you need to put that in parentheses, n plus 1, right? And then add 12. And there's our equation. All right, so let's go ahead and solve it. 3n is 2n plus 2 plus 12. And I'm going to subtract 2n from both sides. And then I'm also going to add the 2 and 12 on the right side of the equal sign. So I get n equals 14. So I know what n is. And what's n stand for? The small, the first number. So n plus 1, the next number is going to be 15, right? So it looks like the numbers are 14 and 15. But let's make sure this all checks out. All right. So it says 3 times the smaller number. 3 times 14 is 42. Okay. Is that the same thing as 12 more than twice the larger? Well, if you got 15, what's twice 15? That means 2 times 15, 30. And if I add 12 to that, I also get 42. So you could check to see that it makes sense that 14 and 15 are the two numbers we're looking for. And so that'll be the answer here. The numbers are 14 and 15. And that's how to do a consecutive integer problem. Now, I'm not going to have time to do a problem about consecutive even and odd integers, but I'm going to do a little introduction here. Let's start out with some examples of 3 consecutive even integers. All right, you know, like 4, 6, and 8. Those are 3 consecutive even integers. Or how about 14, 16, and 18? And of course, you might have some negative numbers like negative 20, negative 18, and negative 16. So if you look at the first integer, how would you get to the next integer? You add 2. So if the first integer is n, what would the next one be? N plus 2. And what would the one after that be if I were to, so this is 2 consecutive integers. If I wanted 3, the next one would be n plus 4. So instead of adding 1, we're going to go by 2's. Now, let's look at examples of 3 consecutive odd integers. All right, let's do some odd integers. How about 7, 9, and 11? Or 23, 25, 27, etc. Well, what happens here? If you know what the first one is, let's say it's n, how would you get to the next odd integer? You don't want to add 1 because you'd be at an even integer, so you have to add 2 to get another odd integer, and then to get to the next odd integer, you'd have to add 2 again. So check this out. Whether you're talking about even or odd integers, they're both defined as n and n plus 2 and n plus 4 if you're doing for 3 in a row. And we'll work on those in another video, problems with those.